Good morning, students. Today we will do differentiation or derivative of an implicit function, and some related problems will be discussed. But what is implicit function? Till date we have done explicit function. In explicit function, y is a function of x, y expressed in terms of x explicitly. But here implicit function, where fxy is equal to 0 and it is not possible or convenient to express y as a function of x, mean it is a combination of x and y, that is fxy is equal to 0, it is expressed in such a way that it is too difficult or not possible to express y in terms of x, then what will be the differentiation and what will be related problem that to be discussed today? Let phi y to find dy dx. In such a case, we differentiate both sides of the given relation with respect to x, keeping in mind that derivative of phi y with respect to x is d phi dx is equal to d phi dy into dy dx. That is like chain rule, whatever you have done. Suppose d dx of sine y, we can write it d dy of sine y into dy dx. So in that case you will get d dy dx into cos y. Similarly, if it is told d dx of y square, you can say d dy of y square into dy dx. Then it will be 2y dy dx. Similarly, d dx of log y, you can say d dy of log y into dy dx. That is equal to 1 by y into dy dx. And if you think about xy, d dx of xy is equal to x into dy dx plus y into d dx of x, that is equal to 1. So you can differentiate with respect to x and you can use mentally the chain rule. Suppose we let us consider the problem 1, x cube plus y cube is equal to 3axy, you have to find out dy dx. Then we will differentiate both sides with respect to x. So d dx of x cube plus y cube is equal to d dx of 3axy. Simply differentiating both sides with respect to x. But ddx of x cube plus ddx of y cube is equal to 3a into ddx of xy. It is 3x square plus 3y square dy dx is equal to 3a into ax into dy dx plus y. Then you will collect dy dx on the left hand side and you will get 3y square dy dx minus 3ax into dy dx is equal to 3ay minus 3x square. Then if you take common 3 dy dx, that is y square minus ax is equal to 3 into ay minus x square. So dy dx is equal to ay minus x square divided by y square minus ax. Mean you should differentiate both sides with respect to x, keeping in mind the chain rule. And after that, you will collect dy dx on the left hand side and then you will find out the value of dy dx. Second problem, if log of x square plus y square is equal to 2 tan inverse y by x, then you have to prove dy dx is equal to x plus y by x minus y. Log of x square plus y square is equal to 2 tan inverse y by x. So differentiating both sides with respect to x, you will get d dx of log x square plus y square is equal to d dx of 2 tan inverse y by x. You know log t, differentiation of log t with respect to x, 1 by t into dt dx. That is, you have considered x square plus y square as t. So 1 by x square plus y square into d dx of x square plus y square. Similarly, you know d dx of tan inverse t, 1 by 1 plus t square. But what is t? T is y by x. So differentiate it again with respect to x. Then you will get 1 by x square plus y square into 2x plus 2y dy dx. is equal to 2 into x square by x square plus y square into division rule here, x into dy dx minus y by divided by x square. After simplification, you will get 2 into x plus y is equal to 2 into x minus y into dy dx. So, dy dx is equal to x plus y divided by x minus y. Similarly, problem number 3, it is another type. If x into root over 1 plus y is equal to y plus y into root over 1 plus x is equal to 0 and it is told x not equal to y, then you have to prove that dy dx is equal to minus of 1 by x plus 1 whole square. We have x into root over 1 plus y into root over 1 plus x is equal to 0. If I consider x into root over 1 plus y, that will be is equal to minus of y into root over 1 plus x. Squaring both sides, you will get x square into 1 plus y is equal to y square into 1 plus x. Bringing all of them in the left hand side and factorize it, you will get x minus y into x plus y plus xy is equal to 0. But it is told x not equal to y. So, x minus y is equal not equal to 0. So, remaining factor x plus y plus xy will be 0. So, y into 1 plus x is equal to minus x. That is, y is equal to minus x by 1 plus x. Now, if you differentiate, here it is x, y expressed in terms of x. No problem. Just like explicit function, find dy dx using division rule. Then you will get 1 into x plus 1 minus 1 into x divided by x plus 1 whole square. So, it is minus of 1 by x plus 1 whole square. So, this third type. All questions, whatever questions I am giving, 4-5 questions, these are 4-5 types. So, check carefully. Another question, question number 4, it is inverse related question. If cos inverse x square minus y square divided by x square plus y square equal to tan inverse A, you have to prove dy dx is equal to y by x. Since cos inverse x square minus y square by x square plus y square equal to tan inverse A, you can say x square minus y square by x square plus y square is equal to cos of tan inverse A. Remember, except x and y, all are constant. So, tan inverse A is constant. So, cos of tan inverse A is again a constant. We consider it as lambda. Now, use componendo dividendo. You know, from class 10th, componendo dividendo. So, here it is using componendo dividendo, you will get numerator plus denominator divided by numerator minus denominator, that is lambda plus 1 by lambda minus 1. You will get finally x square by y square is equal to 1 plus lambda by 1 minus lambda. Again, I consider it is as k, it is a constant. So, you can say x square is equal to k y square. Now, differentiate both sides with respect to x. So, 2x is equal to k into 2y dy dx, because differentiation with respect to x of y square is equal to 2y into dy dx. So, x by ky, that is equal to dy dx. So, if I put the value of k, you will get x by y into y square by x square, that is y by x. So, dy dx is equal to y by x. Here it is inverse related problem. Another problem, that is problem number 5. If sin y is equal to x into sin a plus y, you have to prove dy dx is equal to sin square a plus y divided by sin a. Here, if I check, sin y is equal to x into sin a plus y, so x is equal to sin y by sin a plus y. So, x can be expressed as a function of y only. So, you can say x expressed in terms of y, if I find out dx dy, differentiating both sides with respect to y, not with respect to x. We will find out dx dy and then reciprocal of that, that will be dy dx. So, using division rule, dx dy is equal to sin a plus y into differentiation of denominator, sorry, numerator, that is cos y, minus sin y into cos a plus y divided by sin square a plus y. And if you see the numerator, sin a cos b minus cos a sin b, so that is sin a minus b, that is sin a. So, dy dx is equal to reciprocal of this is equal to sin square a plus y divided by sin a. So, all these 5 questions are of 5 types. So, follow this and I am giving some problems exercise in your PDF. Please solve it and tomorrow again I will do some another topic in differentiation. Thank you.